Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a test of the audio systems and the microphone. Thank you for bearing with me.
Testing 1, 2, testing 1, 2, testing 1, 2.
Good morning, Unity of Madison. Thank you for choosing to spend this time with us, whether you're online or in person. We feel your presence. After the service, if you are present here, we invite you to stay for a question and answer session with Reverend Deborah, and then join us in the Namaste Cafe in the lower level for refreshments. I am Louis Phillips, and I will be your celebration assistant for today. So let's start with our opening song, God Is, We Are.
God is, we are, hallelujah. 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 God is the spark. God is the essence, God is divinity. God is the light, God is the presence. Look within and you will see. God is, we are, hallelujah. God is, we are, hallelujah. God is.
Our prayer chaplain today is Marilyn Mill, and due to the very busy schedule we have, we are not going to have any time for Marilyn to be in the prayer corner, but if you are interested in having prayer support, please consider calling Silent Unity. You can also put written prayer requests in the box over here, and our prayer team will pray for these requests for 30 days and then send them on to Silent Unity for 30 days. So, the opening prayer today is going to be by Marilyn Mill.
Good morning, everybody. Good morning. And good morning to all of you online who are watching our service. So let's just take a few moments to center ourselves. As we take a few deep cleansing breaths, we open to goodness and to possibility. Sweet Spirit, we are grateful to have Reverend Deborah speaking to us as we affirm the sacredness of all of creation. We look forward to her talk, peace and all good. We behold the good that exists in all of ourselves and in the world. We know that the Christ consciousness dwells within us. We go within and connect to our heart space, where we feel the power of peace and love that resides there. We feel this peace and love intensifying as we nurture it with meditation and prayer. We bring these qualities out into our lives and into the world. By presenting in life as beings of peace and love, we create a ripple effect that impacts everyone that we interact with. We see peace and love growing in our world as it grows in our hearts. And with this, all is truly well. And so it is. Thank you, God. Amen.
Okay, now it is time for our congregational song, Welcome Home. Now it is time for our Unity Weekend update. Okay. The speaker schedule on 9/17 is Reverend Tom Wendt, and then on 9/24 is Reverend Richard Bunch via video. And then an intergenerational service will be on 10/1, which will be led by our licensed Unity teacher, Barry Roberts. Not what it said up there?
It was kind of under the sheet of
the
thank you. Okay. All right, we have a fall book study starting this coming week. The book is by Michael Singer. It's called Living Untethered, Beyond the Human Predicament. And it runs for 8 weeks. There are two Zoom classes that you can sign up for out in the foyer. One is on Mondays from 11 a.m. to 12 p.m., and the other one is on Tuesdays from 11 a.m. to 12 p.m. You can get your books in the bookstore, or you can order them through Amazon. And we certainly encourage you to sign up for one of these book study groups. I've been starting the book, and I think it's really excellent, really, really good book. Shamanic Journeying Healing Series continues on Saturday, September 16th, with Jessica Rippenberg, our shamanic practitioner, and it's called Be the Light of Shamanic Healing, and she will guide you on a shamanic journey with a hoop drum, and for details, see our weekly email or the bulletin board in the foyer. The garden team needs helpers next Saturday, September 16th, from 9 till 11 a.m. So anybody who is able and willing to come and do some fall gardening before the parking lot project begins, we would appreciate it. And they will also be working on the regular fall garden tasks. And there's a Qigong class that's meeting on Mondays from 2 until 3:15. It's a 10-week series starting September 18th. The cost is $75, and it's here at Unity of Madison. And it's being led by Kate Lawton. And if you have need of more information, you can go to coloredlightworks.com/Kugen Qigong. Say that 10 times. Okay. There's a chanting and song meditation with Jeremy Anacker coming up on Tuesday, September 19th from 7 till 8:30 p.m. in the sanctuary. You can contact Jeremy at anakerjeremy@gmail.com or his phone number 608-334-1763, or you can visit his website. And also the Unity World Day of Prayer is on September 13th and 14th. The opening ceremony is on September 13th at 7 p.m. It's all virtual, led by a number of Unity ministers. You can register at worlddayofprayer.org. And finally, immediately after the service, we're having a question and answer session with Reverend Deborah. So please stick around, stay in your seats, and we'll go from there. And then eventually, you can go down to the Namaste Cafe and have some refreshments. Also, if you haven't received a survey of today's service, we have ushers that are willing to give them to you, so if you want to let them know, that would be great. There are many more events, and you can visit unityofmadison.org for additional details. Okay, Unity of Madison is a welcoming community, and we welcome anyone joining us for the first time this morning. Unity of Madison is an inclusive spiritual community that welcomes people of all faiths and backgrounds. We acknowledge the wisdom of all spiritual traditions and respect each individual's right to choose a spiritual path. Our goal is to empower and encourage each other in our spiritual journeys. If you would like to know more about Unity of Madison, there's informational packets that are available at the back table. And if you are online, you can request a welcome packet through the website, www.unityofmadison.org, or send an email to office@unityofmadison.org. And now, if you would repeat with me the affirmation for Unity of Madison. Unity of Madison is abundantly blessed. Creative people are drawn to us. Divine ideas flow through us. Financial resources bless us. And with God as our source, we accomplish mighty works together. And now it is time to greet your neighbors in any way that you are comfortable. As we sing, thank you for choosing to be here.
Thank you for choosing to be here.
And now it is time for some introductions. Our musicians today are the Unity All-Star Review and Pete Calgaro. And our speaker today is Reverend Deborah Carr Williams. And I would like to read a little biography for Deborah Carter Williams. Reverend Deborah Carter Williams was ordained as a Unity minister in 1990 and served large Unity ministries in Atlanta, Georgia, Columbus, Ohio, and Naples, Florida. Before her ordination, Reverend Deborah was the youngest person to ever receive a licensed Unity teacher certification. As a licensed Unity teacher, she served the Unity Village Chapel and the Unity Temple on the Plaza in Kansas City, Missouri, as well as Christ Church Unity in Rockford, Illinois. Currently, she is a minister at the Unity Center of Cedar Rapids, Iowa. In 2008, Reverend Deborah left active Unity ministry to embark on an educational journey, a dream she had held for many years. She holds a BA in Religious Studies and Philosophy from Wesleyan College and a Master of Arts in Religion from Yale Divinity School at Yale University, where she received a full academic scholarship and was one of seven students admitted to the theology concentration. Reverend Williams has completed coursework towards the Doctor of Ministry degree at Duke Divinity School at Duke University. Reverend Deborah served as the Director of Campus Ministry and Adjunct Faculty in Religious Studies Department at the historic Wesleyan College in Macon, Georgia, where she led the opening of the newly constructed Pierce Chapel and created interfaith programming for a very diverse student body. Also in Macon, she was a key staff member at a progressive denominational church where her central focus was direct service to the homeless and food insecure in a city where there were extreme levels of concentrated poverty. She co-founded the Middle Georgia Immigration Coalition and served on the Beloved Community Project at Mercer College, which focused on the racial reconciliation in a city and region marked by racial injustice. Additionally, Reverend Deborah is a committed ally of the LGBTQA1+ community and a vocal advocate for inclusion. Reverend Deborah served the Unity Movement as chair of the Licensing and Ordination Committee of the Association of Unity Churches, now called Unity Worldwide Ministries, and currently serves as the chair of the conference team of the Great Lakes Unity Region. Additionally, she has served on several nonprofit boards. She is married to the love of her life, Dr. Don Williams. They have two adult children and a granddaughter that she will brag about at the slightest provocation. So let us welcome Reverend Deborah. Now it is time for our gratitude of the week. This week, we express our gratitude to D. Steele. Yeah. D. has decided it is time to bring her volunteering in the office to a close. She has been volunteering weekly in the office since July 2020. And we thank D. for her dedication and attention to details in volunteering in the office. D will continue to volunteer in other ways at Unity, and if you go downstairs this morning, you'll know why. Thank you for your loving service to Unity of Madison, D. And let us give D our Unity blessing, okay? D. We love you, we bless you, we appreciate you, and we behold the Christ you are. Yes.
Yeah.
time for the special music.
No?
No. Oh, I'm sorry. I missed the Daily Word. Thank you, Pete. Keep me on track over there. The word for today is care. Sometimes my heart goes out to a friend or even a stranger who is struggling. Other times my heart breaks when I learn of another's devastating news. In those moments, I feel the urge to help. I pray, affirming healing, peace, or comfort. I may offer financial support or material goods. I might call on the phone or visit in person. Even so, I may feel my efforts are not enough, especially when the needs are great. But the impulse to care is in many people, the activity of God streaming through so many hearts and hands. As I join my efforts with theirs, I trust we can lift up even the most dire situation. I am a caring presence, ready to help, serve, and love. And the scripture reading is from 1 Thessalonians 2, verse 8. So deeply do we care for you that we are determined to share with you not only the gospel of God, but also our own selves, because you have become very dear to us. And if you would repeat with me the affirmation, which is on the screen, okay. Together, I am here and I care. And now we'll have some special music.
Good morning. So we're going to do a song that we've done before here, but you might not know what it is. But I thought since it's in a different language, I'd let you know what we're singing about, because I'm going to invite you all to sing along. The song's called Funga Alafia. And what Funga Alafia, ashe ashe, those are the words basically. And then we just do the ashe ashe part. But what it means is, with my thoughts, I welcome you. With my words, I welcome you. With my heart, I welcome you. And then the last part, see, there's nothing up my sleeve. So we thought it would be a nice way to welcome Reverend Deborah to us today with Funga Alafia. So we're going to sing it through once, and then once you kind of hear it, it's very easy. It's practically, it's like a kid song, really. We invite you to join us. So here we go. Faster.
Ashe, 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 Ashe.
Well, I feel duly welcomed. Thank you. That was wonderful. Thank you, thank you. It is such a joy to be here with you this morning. And thank you all for your hospitality, for your welcome, for your love. That has really helped to make this weekend a joyous time for my husband and I. I want to thank you so very much for that. It has truly, truly been a joy. And we know that spirit is at work in this process, and that divine order is at work, and we see all unfolding in its right and perfect way for all of us. But again, thank you. I've been very blessed in my life to be able to travel. And I went to Italy about 15 years ago or so, and the highlight of that trip was going to Assisi and to see the Basilica there, and to remember the story of St. Francis of Assisi. That basilica was built very shortly after he passed, which is unheard of. So we know that Francis made an incredible impact, an incredible influence in the lives of people around him. Indeed, as he was sainted afterwards, he lived as a living saint in this world. He loved all creation. And the story of his transformation is one that I think teaches us a great deal. He was the son of a very wealthy merchant. He had lived a very riotous life with his friends. And he found himself in a dark place. He was spiritually searching for something more meaningful, something deeper, richer for his life. And so he was in a little church down at the bottom of the hill from Assisi, and he was praying, and he believed he heard Jesus say to him, "Francis, repair my church." Now, Francis thought that what Jesus was asking him to do was to repair the ruins of the church in which he found himself. But ultimately, it was a higher vision. The church that Francis was part of had lost sight of their essential teachings of love and compassion and honor, and the perception and the view and the affirmation of all creation as sacred and holy. And so Francis was being called to remember that all is sacred, to remember that all is holy, to remember that all of creation is a magnificent expression of the power and the presence and the beauty of God. There is a term in Judaism as well that talks about repairing the world, tikkun olam. And so we find this idea of repairing the world, repairing our communities, repairing our spiritual communities, repairing our own lives, very much threaded through the religions of this world. This idea that we are here as co-creators with God, as participants in creation, to repair the broken places. But where do we first begin? In the peace song, what does it say? Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me. And so the process truly is about moving from center to circumference, transforming our lives, healing and repairing ourselves, pulling together all the fragmented pieces of our own awareness and our own consciousness into a holy unity so that we can be the very instantiation, the very thing itself made manifest. And as we do that, we walk on this earth as a and treat it as if it is the sacred thing that it is, knowing that we are sacred, knowing that we are holy, knowing that we are co-creators with God. There's this wonderful greeting that I sometimes end my emails with. So if you get an email from me, you'll sometimes get this. It's in Latin, it is Pax et Bonum. And it is the greeting, the salutation, also a blessing that Franciscans still give to one another. They give to us if we should meet them. And it simply means peace and all good. Peace and all good. And this blessing can be traced all the way back to Francis. It is a blessing. It is a greeting in which we affirm for each other peace and all that that means. And we affirm for each other that not only we are good, but all creation is good. And that we affirm for one another all the good that God is. It's such a powerful affirmation. It's such a powerful greeting. It is such a powerful blessing. And this idea, this desire for peace, we also see threaded throughout the world's religions as well. Those of us who grew up in a traditional Christian context know this one, peace be with you and also with you. In Judaism, shalom. In Islam, assalamu alaikum. Peace be with you. There is this desire, there is this deep grounding in this notion of peace, this wanting to experience all that that means. And I think it does mean to be grounded in the truth of our being, to be awake and aware and open to the divinity that is within us, but also to know that there is divinity all around us, in each other and in all creation. The story of creation found in the book of Genesis, chapter 1. There's one verse that hangs over into chapter 2. Tells us that God created the world, spoke it into existence, and then said what? It is good. Jesus came to teach us about that as well. That we are good, and that we are holy, and that we are divine. And let's not lose sight of that as well. We are here as expressions of this divine goodness. We are here to make manifest the glory of God, as Marianne Williamson's poem will remind us. We are here to make manifest the glory of God. And so we are also told in this first chapter of Genesis that God created humankind in God's own image, and we are good as well. And what does it mean to be created in the image and after the likeness of God? It means that we have those same attributes. It means that we are beings of power and goodness and life and intelligence and joy and peace, abundance. That's what it means. You know, in Judaism, there is this idea of not having graven images. So if you go to a temple, certainly, or a synagogue, you'll see sometimes stained glass windows, but there's no depiction of God. There's to be truly no depiction of human beings as well. And I think that the reason for that is that it is entirely unnecessary, because the image of God is already imprinted within each and every one of us. We are the image bearers. We are the instantiation of this divine image. We are the thing itself. And as we walk on this earth, we are to walk as that. We are to walk as a co-creator. We are to walk as a steward of this earth. We are to walk as lovers of one another. We are to walk as if we are walking on a pilgrimage, bringing this image into its fullness. Also, on my trip to Italy, I was blessed to go to the Academy in Florence, where stands the colossal figure of Michelangelo's David. It is a figure of a beautiful young man, and as I looked up at this remarkable work, it seemed that he would take a breath at any moment and come alive. And when Michelangelo sculpted, he said that what he was doing is liberating the figure imprisoned in the marble. And in the act of sculpting, he merely chipped away the pieces that didn't belong. And that's our work. We know that we are created in the image and after the likeness of God. And so what we are to do is to chip away the superfluous material in our consciousness so that we liberate this divine image that is within each and every one of us. Charles Fillmore wrote in the book Jesus Christ Heals, "Let the Spirit of God in you reveal to you its true character." I love that. Let the Spirit of God in you reveal to you its true character. Let it reveal to you what you already are, this image likeness that is the truth of your being. And as you begin to walk on this earth as that, you do your healing work. My mother was deathly afraid of thunderstorms. Now, we lived in the South, so guess what? We had quite a few of those. And I don't think outside of a church service I ever heard my mother say a prayer out loud, except when a storm was coming. One rumble of thunder and off she went. My mother grew up in a Protestant church, but she converted to Catholicism when I was a young child. So her prayers were this odd mixture of the rosary, something she learned in Methodist Sunday school. I think what she was trying to do was cover all of her bases just to be on the safe side. So she would stand at the window and she would shout out these prayers to God. And my older brother and I would be rather amused by this, honestly. But that was, in a sense, a metaphor for the way that she handled oftentimes the storms of life. My brother and I grew up in this context. And so the way that we handle storms in life was sort of complementary. I became a minister and my brother became a meteorologist. It was our way of making sense of things, I think. But I think that we can come to know those parts of our awareness that we need to work on, to chip away, to liberate this divine image in us when we are faced with those storms of life. When we are faced with some constricting circumstance, it points us to those places in our awareness where we need to send and focus that healing energy so that that divine image is liberated within us. This morning, I needed to print out my lesson for today. And I often, on Sunday mornings, will get up early and edit it a bit and then print out the final copy. I had a copy with me, but it wasn't the final copy. And I knew that the hotel that we're staying in had a business center. Well, the printer did not work. And so there was a little note on the work table that said, if the printer isn't working, so there must have had this issue before, email it to this email address and we'll print it out for you, which was great. So I did this, I sent it off, and the woman behind the desk did not know how to open the email and print it. And so this beloved woman, we'll call her Diane. I don't want to use her real name because we're being live streamed, but this lovely woman was just so apologetic and really wanted to figure all this out. She was trying to use humor. She was calling everybody she knew. And I said, really, Diane, don't worry about it. It's okay. I have other options. You know, I can use my old copy. I can use my phone. I can use my laptop. I have other options. So I went back up to the room, and about probably less than 5 minutes later, Diane calls and she asks for me, and she says, I did it! I did it! And so I said, oh, thank you so much. And I said, and you've learned a new skill today. Isn't this great? And she says, yes. She goes, it was kind of interesting. When you walked away and I just got still and quiet, it just all came to me. And I thought, there you go. When we just get still and quiet. Because in that stillness and that quietness, we remember who we are. And God opens us in ways, profound ways, that helps us to chip away at that accretion of negativity, perhaps, that we have in our awareness, to chip away anything that doesn't fit into this divine vision for us and our lives. There are spiritual virtuosos on this planet. That's a term that a philosopher, Max Weber, actually a philosopher and a political theorist, talked about. He said that Jesus was one, but also Muhammad and Buddha, Lao Tzu, Francis of Assisi, my friend Diane, perhaps. Spiritual virtuosity is the combination of innate abilities for religious transcendence and sustained, intense spiritual practice that involves reflection, prayer, and meditation. It requires practice, prayer, and meditation. We are called to be spiritual virtuosos. We are called to be like Francis and to see the vestiges, the fingerprints, the power, the presence, the essence of God in all creation as we allow it to reflect to us our own divine image. Just as a musician trains, so must we train our minds. And this is a word we don't like much in our culture, through discipline. Discipline has a negative context. I get that. We have childhood trauma around that. But the idea, the notion of discipline means that we practice. We are committed. We are deliberate. We are always putting this vision out in front of us and doing what we need to do to move into it. That is what we are here to do. And we are here to repair the world in which we live. And we do that first by recognizing this divine image that is imprinted within us, that is the truth of our being, by being committed and deliberate and persevere in the expression of it. The world needs us, friends. Creation is groaning. It needs us, friends. There are places in our world that are broken, but we are not broken. We are whole. We are perfect. We are sacred. We are divine. And you are meant to be the instantiation, the thing itself on this planet, to do the work of healing. Peace and all good.
That is what you are heir to. That is what you are. Peace and all good. So I invite you this week to use that blessing, peace and all good. Now, someone at Hy-Vee or Pick and Save might think you're a little odd, but that's okay. Peace and all good. Because as you claim that for another, you are in truth claiming it for yourself. As you affirm that for another, you are grounding yourself in that consciousness. As you affirm that for another, you are walking on this planet as the very essence of the divine itself. And you are doing your work, just like St. Francis, to repair this world in which we live. God bless you.
And now it is time for our meditation song, Grace is Here.
Love will lead you home. As we prepare now for a time of meditation, I invite you just to allow that love to sustain you, to enfold you, uphold you, and let it lead you home to the center of your being. And as you enter in that sacred and holy space within you, feel a sense of peace moving from the top of your head to the soles of your feet. Peace grounded in love, a love that heals anything unlike itself. Feel that love and peace assuaging any concern or anxiety that you may have brought with you today. Charles Fillmore once said that the very seed of divine love sits just behind our heart. So bring your attention fully to that space. And allow that healing love that is the divine just to radiate from you, to radiate through every fiber of your being, quickening within every cell, atom of your body with healing life and love. We know that mighty currents of healing love flow through you in this moment, to heal, to bless, to bring you peace of mind and heart, so that you are every whit whole, mind, body, and emotions. You are created in the image and after the likeness of divine love. That is the truth of you. So as you allow this radiating center of divine love to express in and through you, send that love into this room as well. Let this divine love that envelops you envelop those around you. The function of love is to heal. The function of love is to join together, to unite. And so in this room, we feel a sense of connection and oneness and healing. And we send forth this love into our community as we accumulate its energy and send it forth to do its good and perfect work. We send it forth into the world, to Morocco, to those who are grieving. We send forth this energy of healing and love with a simple blessing to all creation. Peace, peace, and all good. And so we rest in silence. Open. At peace. Transform. Creator, we thank you. We thank you for your peace that passes all understanding. And we thank you for your love that heals and binds us all together, heart to heart and soul to soul. And so we, as we begin to bring our attention back to this time and to this place, we bring with us a heart filled, overflowing with gratitude. And we say, thank you, thank you, thank you, Spirit. And so it is, and so it shall ever be. Amen.
Hello. So we're going to do a song right now that you may have done before, actually, if you sang with the Unity All-Stars. But even if you haven't done it before, I think you'll figure it out. It's called I Just Want to Celebrate. And especially at the end, we'd really like you to join in, and we'll let you know when that is for sure. The rest of it, there's a lot of words, and I think everybody up here is nervous about fitting in all the words, but we got it. Right?
Right.
Yes. Okay, here we go.
Another day of life. I put my faith in the city.
the Unity All-Star Reviews, everybody. And now it is time for our offering. If you would take your tithes or gifts in your hands and place them over, or place them over your heart as we say our offertory blessing together. Divine love through me blesses and multiplies all that I am, all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive. Thank you, God. Will the ushers come forward, please? And now our offering song, All That I Have. Ushers, come forward, please. And let us all bless the offering. Please join me in blessing the offering. We are grateful for these tithes and offerings. We bless them and send them forth to do their great and mighty works. And so it is. Amen. And now if you would join me in our youth prayer here together, we now open our hearts to the children and families seeking a welcoming spiritual community filled with light and love. And so it is. Amen. And let's invite the kids in.
Yeah. We had a great time, as usual. There were lots of projects happening. If you've been here the last few weeks, you've heard about the jellyfish that we are making together. Yeah, it's coming together nicely, isn't it? Yeah. It's a work in progress. So some of the kids are going to borrow some garbage grabbers here. Do either of you want to talk about what we're doing with the garbage grabbers? How it relates to the jellyfish? You want me to say? Okay. All right. So we're gathering garbage that we find, doing our part to keep the earth and the water clean because it does so much to take care of us. We do a lot of meditation with water. We didn't get to that part today, but we work with the water and earth a lot, so we want to do our part in reciprocity. So this is kind of that reminder that we can bring our garbage in. I've been washing it up so we can add. So a couple of the families are going to borrow these garbage grabbers to collect things, and then you bring the stuff in, I'll wash it. And then, I'll just let you guys share what else you did, because you got some cool stuff going on here.
I'm going to bring this toilet paper roll from my jewel balls.
costume? Okay, so we're always using our imaginations. The kids always come up with the coolest creations. We've got this huge supply of items like, you know, boxes and egg cartons and plastic jugs and stuff. And Linnea today came up with the idea of creating a costume for Halloween. So she, I think, might show it off. Linnea, do you want to show it off? She's got some ears from an egg carton. She's got a tail made from strips of bread bags. And she's got a horse phone that her brother helped her with. One more share, and then we'll move on. Okay. Aria wants to show you guys something. Go ahead. Oh yeah, there was some really good teamwork collaboration in making a very impressive multi-level apartment building for animals, for stuffed animals. Yes, it was very impressive. Yep, go ahead.
Okay, so I thought a lot, and then I thought of using a different thing, and I ended up making what I call my earth jar. So when bugs come in my house, there's little holes in the top of it, but they won't come out, so I can release them back outside.
Thank you.
Wow. Let's join together in giving our youth ed a blessing here. We love you, we bless you, we appreciate you, and we behold the Christ you are. Amen. All right, and now, if the kids want to find their moms and dads or whoever they came with, we will do our peace song. Protection together. The light of God surrounds us. I am light. The love of God enfolds us. I am love. The power of God protects us. I am power. The presence of God watches over us. I am presence. Wherever we are, God is, and all is well. Amen. Everybody, we're going to do the Q&A session in 5 minutes, so let's hang around and take seats. Thank you.